Hello everybody, I'm happy to introduce Dr. Isaac Gerlman. Isaac completed his PhD in physical oceanography at the State Institute of Oceanography at Moscow, Russia. Isaac is head of the Department of Physical Oceanography at Israel Oceanographic and Limnological Research and the head of Israel Marine Data Center at Israel Oceanographic and Limnological Research. Isaac research is concentrated on marine thermohaline structures and circulations, formation stability, long-term changes, marine operational forecasting, oceanographic data bases development, Mediterranean, Dead Sea and Black Sea.
Good afternoon. Okay, I show that you prefer my English and my Hebrew. Both of them not so good, but probably. Okay, so English.
Okay.
So I'll speak about the interannual variability of Eastern Mediterranean, a little bit interannual variability of thermohaline structure. So thermohaline structure, it is a thermal structure and haline structure, because two of these structure is responsible for density. Then field of density and field of density, it is very important for mixing, for stability of the sea, and also for formation of currents. So I will speak a little bit about history, because I have a really long history in oceanography on Eastern Mediterranean, and I will speak about last year's findings we have in this field. So first of all, when we start to speak about some closed sea, we have to speak about water budget, and we need to take into account relation between precipitation, evaporation, runoff, and also water exchange through the straits. And as you can see in this table, Mediterranean Sea is a sea which is really got a lot of water from the Gibraltar, and it is a very low amount of evaporation relative to precipitation, and really strong evaporation relative to precipitation and runoff, and it is different from the, for example, Black Sea. Okay, I will not speak a lot of about Black Sea, but we need to take into account that first of all, sea where runoff and precipitation less than evaporation, and this is the number of precipitation, runoff and evaporation is less than evaporation, it is so the sea is called as concentration basin, because it always get more and more water from ocean, not go out water, but get through the straits. And there is a very interesting hydrological regime for this kind of sea. First of all, sea level is less than in adjacent ocean, you see, and we have always gradient current in upper and upper layer. So if you have also water go out from the Gibraltar, it is connected with differences in water density, but we have in sum, we have input of water from the Gibraltar. And in this kind of sea, we have so-called overturn hollow climb, because it is a very strong evaporation, increased salinity in upper layer, and overturn hollow climb, it is maximum salinity in upper layer. And if you have maximum salinity in upper layer, what will happen during winter? It will be cooling, and this water will be very, very heavy, dense, and will be deep, or some intensive convection during winter. It is what we have in the Mediterranean. So it is concentration basin, which is ventilated relative good. If we compare with Black Sea, it is a dilution basin, where we have not overturn hollow climb, but main hollow climb, which is prevent winter convection. Okay, so field of salinity, because field of salinity it is key for hydrological regime of the Mediterranean. Input in Gibraltar, it is relative low salinity water, about 36 gram per kilogram salinity, which is comes through the Gibraltar. And this water you can see, and the minimum salinity here, and increase of salinity in this direction. In here, in our regional, in southeastern Mediterranean, we have maximum salinity during summer, and also it is during winter. Temperature is not so important, probably, for understanding of hydrological life of the sea, but no doubt is very strong influence also on field of density. And here we can see what's happened with the water which has come to the Gibraltar. It is low salinity water. Here we can see minimum salinity in upper layer, and this is a station which is along of the Mediterranean. And when we go from west to east, signal of Mediterranean of Atlantic water is less and less, you see. And in our regional, it is very very low signal of Atlantic water, but in the same time, in the upper layer, we have a development of new layer with maximum salinity. So it is so-called Levantine surface water. So it is just a transformation from Atlantic water due to evaporation, intense evaporation, and increase of salinity. And we have here already maximum salinity, which is responsible for convection in development of intensive convection in the sea. Winter field salinity is about the same, a little bit mixing, at least in southern part of the sea, and temperature is also not so strong cooling, but here certainly we have much more warm water than in the north regions, and finally field of density you can see here. So white water in the south part, after that water is going to the cyclonic circulation here, and it's going to the north, and the cooling of water leads to increase of salinity in this region, in region of agency, and continue to go to the Adriatic Sea, and maximum salinity we have here and here. So it was found that in region where density in upper layer is more than 28.8, it is region with formation of intermediate water, because there is cooling, increase of density, it is going down with convection, and after that it spreads already in intermediate layers. And the regions where density is more than 21.1, it is already formation of deep water. So we can see region for intermediate, it is this color, and deep water, it is three different regions.
Can I ask, what's the meaning of that in the Adriatic?
Sorry?
What's the meaning of deep water in the Adriatic?
What do you mean?
What's the meaning of deep water in the Adriatic?
It is water which is formed in the middle of the Adriatic, and after that it go out through the Otranto Strait and go in all Eastern Mediterranean region. I will speak about this. So first of all, let's speak about LAW. LAW, it is a formation, Levant Intermediate Water, it is maximum of water formation in this region, where we have Rhodes Gyre, it has some dome structure, and on this dome structure, it is Levant surface water is cooled down, and after that increase of density and spreading as LAW. And parameters of LAW is a relative constant, but it's not, no doubt it depends also from intensity of winter and salinity, which is start from Levant surface water salinity also. So three water, not we speak about not deep water, but three water It is typical for our regional. So Levantine surface water, you see, it is histogram of salinity and depths of the Levantine surface water, and the maximum of the this circle, it is the probability, maximum probability of this water. And it is a blue one, it is Atlantic water also, and it is Levantine intermediate water. It is statistical, it is climate for our regional. It is typical water, and you can see also that it is variable, this variability is quite strong. It's quite strong. About deep Mediterranean water. So, Western Mediterranean deep water, it is formation in so-called Leon Basin. Leon Basin, it is a strong cooling, very, very, very strong heat loss, loss of heat storage, and formation of water with higher density and relative stable parameters of temperature and salinity. So this water is going down in Leon Basin. So in not so many places in the world where you can find intensive development of convection like it is in Leon Basin. So deep convection until 2 kilometers until bottom, it is just you can find in Greenland Sea, North Atlantic, in also in Sea of Weddell, and in Leon Basin. So Leon Basin with relative warm weather conditions, which is really warm, if you can compare it with Arctic and Antarctic weather. So it is a very good place to make investigation of in development of deep convection. And it was really done, and a lot of our models about deep convection was built on measurements in Leon Basin. But for us, it is very important, like a place for deep water formation. This water is not going to mix with the water from Eastern Mediterranean, because Sicily site is relative shallow, and this water just remains in Western Basin. When we are speaking about Eastern Mediterranean, so it is Adriatic Sea, salinity is not so high. It is always get salinity from the upper layer of the Atlantostrate. It is cooling down very, very strong in this region, and after that, when it is reached density about 29.2, it is go out through Atlanta and fill all Eastern Mediterranean. So it is another place. And also there is some place here in Aegean Sea, in the middle of the central basin of Aegean Sea, but a lot of time it was not accepted that it is a place for a big amount of water formation. Major place of formation, it is Adriatic Sea, and the parameters of water, of deep water parameters, was very, 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 very stable with time. Just to close a little bit this picture, so Atlantic water come from the Gibraltar, going to the Western Basin to the Eastern Basin. Transformation in upper layer, increase of salinity, increase of temperature, going to the east with cyclonic circulation, going to the Rhodes Gyre. Rhodes Gyre is cooling down. It is formation of LAW, you see LAW as intermediate water, and intermediate water LAW go through the Sicily Strait, go out through the Sicily Strait, and also go out from the Gibraltar, and spreads in Atlantic in, on the level about 1,000 meters. So it is very important for all climate of all our Earth, because it is very important, it is make modulation of convection in North Atlantic. So salinity of the Eastern Mediterranean is very important also for all processes of global conveyor belt and all processes of weather formation in our Earth. It is just a picture to show that the Sicily Strait. You can see in upper layer it is going water going in from the western part to the eastern part, and LAW going from the east part to the western part. It is also data was accepted not so out of time ago. So we can conclude a little bit on this stage of our presentation that we have three type of conveyor belt. First one, it is Atlantic water, which is going along of the coast of Africa, and after that got transformation. This you see strong evaporation in this region, increase of salinity, going to the Rhodes Gyre, LAW formation, and after that LAW going to the Atlantic. And another two conveyor belts, it is the deep water formation in the western basin. So water comes to the surface and cool down during winter, going to the bottom, and after that very slowly it is going up. But this deep water does not it's possible to say it is a very small amount of mix with LAW, but some amount certainly it is mixed. So it is this kind of conveyor belt. And another conveyor belt, it is in the eastern part of Mediterranean, deep water formation in Adriatic, and go out through the Otranto and fill all this region, and also some amount of water is deep water formation there is here. And as I told, the first guess of our knowledge, it was that it is a very intensive part, and it is very very slow part of deep water formation. So we just mentioned about the global circulation of Mediterranean. Let's speak about development of knowledge in the surface circulation. And the surface circulation, it is also very interesting and very important. The first knowledge was accepted not from the measurements of by current meters, because measurements of current meters is very expensive and very difficult. So first knowledge was accepted from measurements of temperature and salinity. You can see some core of the water which is moved, and we can make some conclusion. And the first good measurements in the Mediterranean, it was from the research ship of Thor, and you see a very small amount of data, but some conclusion about general cyclonic circulation was already accepted, was received. But you see, it is not so many gyres, it is just a general picture cyclonic circulation. With the accumulation of historical data, for example, in 76 already a lot of station and new knowledge, and the picture of current, it is much more detailed, and we have already some gyres, some eddy. But location of this eddy was not definite finally, because sometimes it does exist, sometimes it does not exist. But it was clear that it is necessary to make very, very accurate and dense measurements to find and to make description of these vortices. And in period from 86 and 90, it was already done a very dense grid of stations with time scale resolution about 50 kilometers, 100 kilometers to make description of these gyres. First of all, it was found that these gyres there is in Atlantic, and after that it was clear that there is also in the Mediterranean. It was some knowledge about Western Mediterranean, but it was a completely empty place in the Eastern Mediterranean. And only when these measurements by efforts of a lot of countries, you can see that a lot of countries participated, it was done, it was found very interesting picture of circulation. And really, after poem, circulation in Ionian Sea was not clear completely, because you see, it was not direct here. It is because it is near to the roof, it is not possible to make Libya, it is not possible to make measurements. And only from Soviet ships, we also, in this time I was participated in very similar cruises from the Soviet Union, and we have possibilities to work here. Now this data already in our database and everybody can use it and it is free. But here it was done relative good measurements and without some thousand part near to the Egyptian coast, but here it was data was very interesting. And what is a major finding? It's mid-Mediterranean jet. You see mid-Mediterranean jet which was not earlier in any scheme. It is Rhodes Giant was already on the map of Ovchinnikov. It was accepted that it is a cyclonic circulation in this region. It is very strong. Shikmona Giant, it was a new one. Mersa Matruh, it was not also in some maps of Ovchinnikov already Mersa Matruh was, but in some was not. So it is also a confirmation of existence. This eddy, small eddy, with name Ira Petra. Here it's not written, but it is after that he got name Ira Petra. Also Pelops, very strong anticyclonic gyre. And so you see picture already very, very interesting, very in a lot of life in this picture. After that, it was development of knowledge together with modeling. And in 2005, Nadia Binardi already published this scheme. So you see, general picture, general circulation, it is the same. But already mid-Mediterranean jet exists, and major anticyclonic feature, already exists in the circulation. But together with this scheme, it started very big discussion, if it's really good, if it's really right scheme. Claude Millot, it is a scientist from French, is a very good scientist, very good knowledge about Western Mediterranean, but a little bit less about Eastern Mediterranean. He worked a lot of this sea surface temperature from satellites. And he told, announcement was that really mid-Mediterranean jet does not exist. All gyres here along the, it is results of longshore currents, as meandering of longshore currents. And mid-Mediterranean jet is just artifact because measurements was done here, and it is the results of just artificial connection of data about mid-Mediterranean. And it started huge discussion, a lot of investigation and measurements, and we also took part in this. We started to see what is the for example origin of the Shikmona Gyre that is near to our region. You see, it is the Shikmona Gyre, and it is also part of the Mediterranean jet. So Israel Shadrach also started to work in measurements a lot of here, and also Cyprus. Oceanographical Center also work a lot in this region to get information. So we found that sometimes Shikmona Gyre, for example, is really located here. It is really constant, but sometimes it doesn't exist. We cannot find. Structure is more or less the same stable structure, so you can see downvarying of all the surfaces and the temperature and salinity and density. You can see very typical profiles in this region, but the nature of the eddy was not clear. It was not clear how it's formed. What is the start of the formation of the eddy? And sometimes we got more and more knowledge. And a very big help was also from Dr. Zadiatis, which is did a lot of measurements south of Cyprus, and he found that the picture is really much more complicated than we can imagine. That it was accepted by Poem. He found that sometimes there is a eddy on place, on typical place of Shikmona, there was sometimes other eddy. And when he started and he gave a different name, he told, okay, it is not Shikmona, it is Cyprus eddy. Our first guess was, okay, George, the artist just wanted to change a name to this eddy, not to, to accept Shikmona, accept Cyprus eddy. But with time it was understood. So sometimes the theory exists two eddies. And we separated according to names. Some eastern part, the eastern eddy we call Shikmona eddy, and western as the Cyprus eddy. And one finding was very important, that it was always existence of mid-Mediterranean jet. So Claude Millot was not right in one thing. He told that mid-Mediterranean jet is artifact. It does not really exist. It was constant. It does really exist. It is very, very seldom you can find some not real picture of current in this region. Usually you can find this current, this jet, very, very, very clear. And we also, in this time, we started to use another equipment, so-called Lagrangian current meters, together with some our Italian colleagues. And we found that one thing which was told by Claude Millot also right. We found that Shikmona eddy, it is really a result of longshore current and formation of meander, first of all, and after that this meander can be separated from the current, and after that he makes some stable position in this region of Shikmona. So formation, it is instability, hydrodynamic instability of current, and after that it is stable position here, it is results of topography and wind field. So It was clear. So from about formation of eddies, Claude Millot was right. It is very often it is a result of formation of from meander of longshore current. But mid-Mediterranean jet, it is really exist. It is a very 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 important feature of Eastern Mediterranean.
These are measurements of surface water.
Yes, it is a drifter. Drifter, it is just buoyancy with some parachute on the depth about 5 to 10 meters, and with the GPS and connection with satellites, and it's just transmit position of this. It was finally, it was hundreds of drifters was launched. And a very interesting picture of currents was achieved. I will show you. One very interesting thing that you also can see, we didn't know about this, you can see detachment of the eddy on the field of chlorophyll from the satellites. You see, it is an example of field of chlorophyll together with drifters we are launched. You see the very, very good coinciding of field of chlorophyll with dynamic structure here. And it is confirmation also currents and also chlorophyll measurements from satellites. Very important results. And now theory of exchange from coastal water to the open sea water, it is a very good, very good confirmation from this data. And here you can see now accepted last publication about this. It was published in 2012. Results of measurements by Lagrangian currents and Lagrangian current meters, and also satellites sea surface anomaly together with this. And you can see these longshore currents, formation of eddies in our region, Rosas Gyre, it is a really constant appearance. Mersa Matruh, anticyclonic gyre, it is also relatively stable formation. Here, You can see red some eddy, Cyprus eddy and Shikmona eddy, but there is a migration of this eddy. You can find, you cannot find it constantly. Ira Petra eddy, it is a relative constant formation also. So this picture already got some acceptance from ethnographic community. And now I just want to speak about another phenomenon which was discovered in the Mediterranean during last already 30 years. And as I told, it was accepted that Adriatic Sea was my major source of deep water. But and we thought that it is really constant. For example, in according to measurements in 1987, we got this, it was all basin, all measurements for all basin on the relative dense grid, and we got numbers of temperature and salinity water and volume of water, number of salts, number of quantity of salts, quantity of heat storage from this. And for us, it was clear that now it is stable. At least in this deep water, in LAW, it will not any changes. Certainly upper layer, like this, it is it was summer picture, it is winter picture, TS diagram. So deep water and levative water, it is the same. But changes certainly exist, seasonal changes in upper water. And we have had these numbers, temperature, salinity, volume, entropy, and salt quantity, and it was stable numbers. But not everything was so easy. Also about circulation. Conveyor belt was first for Eastern Mediterranean, was shown by David Anati, oceanographer from Jerusalem University. And you see, David Anati thought, okay, maximum water from Adriatic, some amount from Aegean Sea, After that, it is Atlantic water, it transformed to LAW, and this go out. And Anati also in his PhD work, he told that the picture is quite stable. But you see, it was this pass of water, which is not really confirmed by other scientists. Other scientists not really accepted it. One thing more, which was accepted by Anati, at least was suggested by Anati. Anati told, okay, deep water convection, there is in Leon Basin. But I think that Rhodes Giant, it is also a place where we just did not found deep water formation. It should be. But in future, we will find it. And it was a lot of people which was not agree with Anati. But in 87, it was the first time that we found that, okay, really, it is in Rhodes Gyre, in this region, there is a strong convective chimney, formation of convective chimney on until depths 1,000 meters. So Picnic Line was destroyed, and temperature and salinity was changed on the deep layers in about 1,000 and more than 1,000 meters. So it was new feature in Eastern Mediterranean, and it was also it was some discussion: is it really new? It is just we did not have the data before this, so it was necessary to confirm some opinion. About the same time, we also make observation in this region near to the Cretan arc strides. And we found that a huge amount of water, salt water, go out from this Cretan arc strides. But we were not sure that it is connected with some big phenomena. In the same time, we found this Ira Petra gyre, a strong, very strong gyre, about 1 meter per second currents, and also Pelops gyre, about the same energetic feature structure. And we were so surprised to this, and all our attention was on this. So we just did not put attention to these very interesting things. But also measurements, it was about on the depth of 1,000 meters. On 1,000 meters, you can see very strong gradients of temperature and salinity. Deeper this layer, really equipment we used in Soviet Union ships was not good enough to be sure that there is some small changes. It was already, but our equipment was not good enough. And only in 1995, when Meteor did measurements in Mediterranean, these sections, it was found that deep water interior was changed completely. You see, in 87, for example, you haven't salin water here. In 95, it already was found that this water exists, and it was clear that this water was not formed during 1995. It was formed purely, and people started to find where it started to deep new old and new data, and to find explanation to this very big phenomenon. As I told, our opinion it was that, okay, it is constant here, we can check our equipment, it is constant temperature, constant salinity, but if there is some changes, probably it's not good equipment. No, it was very good equipment, it was very good, very strong changes in salinity and in temperature, strong, I mean, well, integral value. So absolute value, it was about 0.1 in salinity, 0.1 in temperature, not so big. And so all scheme of Anati was changed. In this time it was found that Adriatic Sea is stopped to work, it stopped to produce deep water. And Aegean Sea started to produce deep water in intensity about 10 times more amount of water than it was produced by Adriatic Sea. So completely new picture. And if you will now to try to follow about all changes, we can see it is before transient. Before transient, you see temperature and salinity, it is monotonic decrease until bottom. So it is here, it is only old water from Adriatic origin. In 89, as it was clear after analysis of a lot of amount of data, it was clear that Adriatic Sea stopped to work and Aegean Sea started to produce big amount. And the data of 1990 was clear that it is results of this new role of Aegean Sea. In 1995, Meteor found that in the depths you have saline water, strong saline water. On the TS diagram you can see it was monotonic decrease. Now you see monotonic decrease, and after that increase temperature and salinity near to the bottom. So completely replacement of deep water. But not completely, in this region, yes. Here you can see, but in our region, eastern from about 30-29, you cannot see. It is still old water, which was formed in Adriatic. Again, we will continue after that. First of all, let's try to understand where is it origin of this water, how Aegean Sea can produce this very dense water. And We started to investigate data of Greek oceanographers, and here you can see section in Cretan Sea. And in Cretan Sea in 87, there is not any water with density 29.2. March, there is not. October already exists, but you see near to the bottom. So it is not a formation as a vertical convection. It is just advection. So we need to find where the place of advection. And 1889 already a lot of huge volume of the dense water. In 92, it was very cold winter. In 92, it was all the Indian Basin was full with this high density water. And after that, in 94, it started already relaxation. It started to decrease of level of this water. After analysis of some data, a very dense data, you see it as a huge amount of station was done during winter. Now we are not able to make something like this. So it was clear, okay, that is still this a little bit. It was clear that you see it is section along of the Aegean Sea, and most of dense water, it is central basin, it is here. And what was clear is that water with high salinity water come in this place, it's cooling down on this shelf, go to the central basin, it go through Kyklades and go to the Cretan basin. So it is the region of formation, not Cretan basin, but here. It's not an evident result, but it is what confirmed by a lot of measurements. So it is a picture, schematic picture. So deep water formation on the shelf, and also Kyklades, and after that Kyklades and deep water formation in going cascading in the Cretan basin. Okay, how this influence of Eastern Mediterranean transit was in our region? Let's see. In our region, earlier, all the profiles of salinity was like this, you see? It was monotonic degrees of salinity. First time we can see increase near to the bottom in 1996, it was first time. Did you see? And after that, after 2002, it was some gap in data. It was already constant maximum salinity in the region. So it, in our region, come water in depths, come water from the Aegean Sea. And then you can see also, it was before transient temperature salinity. And it is now temperature and salinity in after transient, which we have now. And data 2001, all our regional has saline and warm water net at the bottom. But here you see there is new water. It is new water. It has already stopped to work Aegean Sea, but Adriatic Sea start to produce new water, which is less, a little bit less saline and colder, but it's the same density. So transient was converted, and all the situation just returned to what it was before transient. Adriatic Sea started the war, Aegean Sea stopped. And it is again a continuation of movement in 2008, so propagation of Adriatic water more to the east. And on the TS diagram we can see monotonic increase for the transient, and it is already new water from the Adriatic. So we also can see it is near to the Cyprus in 2012. Here you see this canyon, and you can see this water is here. It is new water already come, so in east, and but near to our coast, in here, it is still not exist because it is a little bit less dense. Depth of water is not so big like in previous slides. So it is water is not still here. Okay, what is the reason of Mediterranean transient? So major reason, as it's possible to say, as Laskaratas said, that first of all, changes in air, sea, heat and fresh water budgets. So budgets is always very important. And changes in circulation, as it was told by Malinotto Rizzoli. But it is a common word, so what some details still were not clear. Some attempt of modeling by Pinardi and Demirov, they found that the increase of salinity increase of salinity here in our region, and the propagation of this water high salinity in Aegean Sea, it is the reason. And they really found that North Atlantic oscillation can lead to increase of salinity during this period. Another step to understanding was done by people from Italy, as Miro Gacic, and he found that it is possible to explain in terms of cyclonic and anticyclonic circulation in the Ionian Sea. So there is some periods with about 10 years, 7 years, that, for example, if you have here anticyclonic circulation, what's happened? Atlantic water comes from the Sicily Strait, going in the north and going to the Adriatic Sea. Adriatic Sea got less saline water and starts to there is decrease of deep water formation because it is low salinity in Adriatic. And in the same time, less Atlantic water come in our region, in Eastern Mediterranean, and saline water come to Aegean Sea, and Aegean Sea started to work. And when it reverses, so we have relative fresh water, Atlantic water come in our region. Our region became less saline, and after that, here water in the Adriatic, we have only after strong transformation in this region. So this scheme looks very, very logical and interesting. So we just wanted to check this scheme with our data, and we have a lot of data in this region, and also we make some Haifa section. It is good data, not so many stations, just Haifa section. It is just 6 stations there from Haifa, but we have a relative good time series already, and this data you can find, for example, okay. You can find in our database, it is free, just need to register it and to download this data, everybody can use it. And we found that in our region we have increase of salinity, very, very slow increase of salinity, and increase of temperature also. It is interesting results, and we try to explain it. An explanation for this slow increase, it is probably lack of fresh water, which is we can feel after damming of Nile. And this fluctuation, it is connected with cyclonic and anticyclonic circulation in the Ionian Sea. In the Ionian Sea. Also, we have increase of salinity in Atlantic water, and we have increase of salinity in NLW. So we are in the age when all Eastern Basin got more and more saline water. How it will be changes in the future, it is really difficult to say. Okay, it is just a comparison. So for example, with data and this, for example, this 84-94 period, We have really increase of salinity, and it is possible to see 84, 95, it is salinity, and after that transient. And we have also increase, which coincide with anticyclonic circulation, this increase, but it was not strong enough, after that it started decrease, so we haven't another transient again. But Some correlation exists, not so strong because we haven't a lot of data. Okay, it is. Thank you very much. It is what I wanted to say.
Thank you very much, Isaac. Is it time just for one short question?
Do you have any estimates how the deep water temperature and salinity changed in the Eastern Mediterranean?
It was about 0.1 salinity, 0.1 temperature. If we are speaking in the region...
You're talking about the transient?
Yes, during transient. So before transient and during after transient, in near to the Cretan arc straits, you can find the temperature and salinity about 0.1 plus.
Can you estimate what were the changes on longer time scales? Like the time scale of maybe deglaciation?
No, we have data. We can make a lot of speculation about this, but to say something for sure we can't. You see, it is salinity 38, 68, and 78, and temperature 35, a little bit more than 0.1.
Okay, thank you very much.